Mr. Azizan, the question I have for you now is, in this year's virtual M100 Awards presentation, what was your initial reaction after hearing your organization's name announced as the winner of the two sectors, actually, accounting and professional services, and also for the consulting services, the sectors? And what does this mean to you and your organization?
Well, we were so thrilled and, of course, very thankful. But the experience in watching the award announcement online is not the same as being dressed up in suits and black tie at a gala dinner, especially getting excited going on stage receiving the award. However, the team made the most of the situation by getting together in a small group, waiting for the award announcements full of suspense. And when we saw the results on screen, Ken, one of our team members, held up his laptop with the results on the screen with a big smile and in full of pride instead of the M100 trophy. The atmosphere was different, but surely there was a lot of joy and appreciation in the firm. With the pandemic, we had to reimagine the possible in the way we engage with the students on campus. Speaking to students from our home rather than in a packed career event has become our new normal. And to be honest, we were not sure whether we were able to build strong presence among the students and graduates, especially when we were not able to meet them face to face. Given the challenges which we had to quickly adapt to, the award really meant a lot to us. We are glad to know that students have continued to vote for us as their employer of choice, even when they only see us online. So thank you so much for your votes. And definitely, the M100 Awards encourage us to increase our efforts to reach out to students even more.
Season. With the M100 Awards 2020 over and done with, what are your ambitions for the M100 Awards for 2021? As in the company's ambitions as well? Maybe you can share some with us.
2021 will be another challenging year ahead, but we will continue to work very closely with the students and the student bodies and continue to understand what they want in their future career. At the same time, we also hope to develop and upskill them to help them to enter the workforce, which I feel will be a different world to compare to what it was before the pandemic, as many organizations look into new ways of working.
What are some tips or advice for students or fresh graduates to encourage them to step out of their comfort zones and strive for excellence?
My advice to all students and fresh graduates, have the courage to venture into the unknown. Seize the opportunities which come your way, even if it isn't related to your field of study or if it's not what you're looking for. In this current situation, you may also find it a bit more challenging to secure your first job, as the country, the economy will take some time to recover from this global crisis. Therefore, you have to find ways to differentiate yourself from the others who are also trying to get employed. Take on any roles that can help build skills that you would use in the future, especially the digital skill. Digital skill together with human skills such as agility, critical thinking, problem-solving skill, communication, you will get the human difference, differentiating yourself from the others. And all work experiences matter. You may have worked as a waiter or in sales during your studies, although during the pandemic, these opportunities may be limited. But some of this experience you have gained will be very useful for your CV or during your interviews when you apply for jobs. Lastly, be patient and be vigilant always, and good things come to those who wait.